Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Deep Cuts Reactions and my name's Greg. And I wanted to play a song that people have told me about. It's apparently a really famous song in Australia. And it's about the campaign in World War I in Turkey, the Gallipoli campaign, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, when so many people were killed on both sides. It was the Anzac forces were deployed, Australia, New Zealand, and then also Canadian forces. I'm not sure who else, but it was carnage, absolute carnage. And when I was looking at this little video, I mean, down at the bottom of the video, they were, you know, talking about it. And I guess somebody made this for Canadian Day or something. But it was, like I say, originally done for Anzac Day, I believe. And it's supposed to be, you know, quite the anti-war song. So I don't know. I haven't heard it. So let's go ahead and check it out. And I certainly don't own copyright. So here we go.
Now when I was a young man, I carried me pack, and I lived the free life of the rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, well, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time you stop rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat and they gave me a gun, and they marched me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as the ship pulled away from the quay. And amidst all the cheers, the flag waving and tears, we sailed off for Gallipoli. And how well I remember that terrible day, how our blood stained the sand and the water, and of how in that hell that they called Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter. Johnny Turkey was waiting, he'd primed himself well, he showered us with bullets and he rained us with shell, and in 5 minutes flat he'd blown us all to hell. Nearly blew us right back to Australia. But the band played Waltzing Matilda when we stopped to bury our slain. We buried ours and the Turks buried theirs. Then we started all over again. And those that were left, well, we tried to survive in that mad world of blood, death and fire. And for 10 weary weeks I kept myself alive, though around me the corpses piled higher. Then a big Turkish shell knocked me arse overhead, and when I woke up in me hospital bed and saw what it had done, well, I wished I was dead. Never knew there was worse things than dying, for I'll go No more waltzing, Matilda. All around the green bush, far and free, to hum tent and pegs, a man needs both legs. No more waltzing, Matilda, for me. So they gathered the crippled, the wounded, the maimed, and they shipped us back home to Australia. The legless, the armless, the blind, the insane, those proud wounded heroes of Suvla. And as our ship pulled into circular quay, I looked at the place where me legs used to be, and thank Christ there was nobody waiting for me. To grieve, to mourn, and to pity. But the band played Waltzing Matilda as they carried us down the gangway. But nobody cheered, they just stood and stared. Then they turned all their faces away. And so now, every April, I sit on me porch, and I watch the parade pass before me. And I see my old comrades, how proudly they march, reviving old dreams of past glories. And the old men march slowly, all bones stiff and sore. They're tired old heroes from a forgotten war. And the young people ask, what are they marching for? And I ask myself the same question. But the band plays Waltzing Matilda, and the old men still answer the call. But as year follows year, more old men disappear. Someday no one will march there at all. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, who'll come a waltzing Matilda with me? And their ghosts may be heard as they march by that billabong. Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Well, that's an absolutely chilling song. I don't know. I've known people that went to war, known them closely, and, you know, they're never the same. Even if they come back uninjured, they're never the same. That was a horrible, horrible war, World War I, and here in the United States, we don't really grasp the depth of it. You know, we got into the war very late, you know, and didn't realize, or didn't. It was Britain's war, you know, initially, and they were in it for a long time before we ever got in it, and they lost a generation, you know. The whole British Empire lost a generation. It wasn't just England, you know, but Australia and New Zealand, Canada, India. Horrible thing. And still there's war. And you've got to wonder why. I mean, power or what? I don't know. I don't know why we have a war now, except we have an insane man that started it, you know, and it's not like you can just walk away. You know, they can't just walk away in Ukraine. What do? You fight, and it's on one hand senseless, and on the other hand, what can you do? You know, so I don't know. That was a very moving song. So I really didn't expect something. I'm going to have to go for a while before I come back and try to do another video. That was a little too intense. So anyway, you know, I know that the photographs on there and everything, and some of the figures that the guy gave, I mean, it was just a person putting together a video, and they screwed up a bunch of times, but, you know, they got the gist of it, you know, which is death and carnage. But anyway, I will be back later, and we'll play something else. And in the meantime, you know, hit like, subscribe, and I'll see you in an hour or two or something like that. I don't know. But in any case, yeah, hit like, subscribe, and all that stuff, and we'll talk to you then. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.